What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. This is part two of the Epic Mickey Rebrushed demo. So we're gonna switch on over to our console capture. We weren't able to finish the game in our first playthrough, so there's no save points in this demo, so I had to play through everything we did before again here, and I'm back to where we were. So this is where we were in the area, very vibey, spooky area, abandoned theme park area, and we got classic Disneyland rides like the teacups over here. We got the Dumbo ride over here as well, and looking forward to what else there is to do in the demo. I'm assuming I'm very close to the end, but I did want to record this and do this as a video instead of just doing it off camera. So we're going to talk to our man over here, Tim. Thank you for taking care of all the bloatings. If you have the time, there are other rides here that need your help, Mickey. I'd love to start the ride, but it seems the machinery is broken. I need my wrench. I was working on a spinning cup with a red stripe on top of it when the splatters attacked. Haven't seen it since. If you're willing to help, come see me near the machine behind the elephant ride.
Alright.
So we gotta help him get these rides up and going, I believe. Hopefully the audio sounds better than the last time we recorded this, because you could barely hear the game in the last one. It was loud in my ears, but it wasn't coming across well on stream, so hopefully it's coming across better in today's video. I did mess with the settings. I had to raise it in game, so I think that's helping a lot. I cannot wait to play this full game in October. It's gonna be a vibe. All right, so he said to meet him behind the elephants. Oh, look at this. It's all janky, not running properly. Can we break these? Yes, we can. I don't know if we should. Is this a hidden Mickey? Right? Would you call that a hidden Mickey? A bush shaped like Mickey's head? You know, something I noticed while I was playing through this is that you can always see Mickey's two ears no matter what angle you're in. You see this? As I move the camera around, his ears just kind of move around too, so you always see both of them from every angle. And I think it does that in the cartoons as well. You always see Mickey's both of his ears. You never get him in an angle where you can't, where you just see like one ear and the other one's hidden behind the other ear. So I think that's a pretty cool attention to detail that they put in the game. Let's fill this in. I think so. Make a big elephant push. Oh, look at that. Pretty. Anything hidden in here? Yep. Got him. Fill it in. Fill it in. I feel like Walt Disney designing the park right now. Is it Oswald? Fill this in. I think that's Oswald, yeah. Alright, here's our man, Tim. Still haven't found it. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the spinning cup had a red stripe. I remember because red is my favorite color. Red stripe. You still haven't found it. Without that wrench, I'm powerless. Well, I can still teleport and fly, but other than that, I'm powerless. Not much of a hero, huh? Is it like hidden in one of these things? Oh, he said it was by the teacups, right? So he probably lost it over here. Once we find it, we'll go give it to him. Try to interact with as much stuff as we can. Fill this in. Wait, was that like a... What is that? Oh, that's his tail. I thought that was like a... something that we could turn. It might be like in the teacup ride itself, I'm assuming. I'm just trying to interact with everything. You guys probably can't hear this, but my controller is vibrating like every single time I attack. It's kind of annoying. So I'm probably gonna have to turn that off. Alright, let's check inside the teacup. We probably definitely just dropped it in one of these, I'm assuming. Right? Oh, why is... Oh, this is trippy. Oh. Can we interact with this? Oh, we can't get inside of it? Oh, no. There we go. There we go. Maybe in the middle? Maybe this somewhere around here? I don't see it anywhere. Oh wait, do we have to? Can we? No, we cannot. I thought we could maybe get rid of these teacups and see inside of them using the thinner. But it does not look like we can. Oh! Hidden room? Oh, there's a treasure chest back there. How do we get over there? Maybe from this side? There might be a way in. Oh, the boat? Oh, maybe this is where we're supposed to go. I don't know. Well, let's just go. I mean, there is a Mickey symbol here, so I'm assuming this is where we're going next. Maybe we don't have to do the wrench thing right now. Or maybe that was a side thing. And this is like the main quest area. That's probably what it is. Oh, that is a shame, because I kind of wanted to find the guy's wrench for him. Well, this ride isn't fixed at all. Look at these boats jammed in here. Some are even overturned. That door should have automatically opened, but I guess it's broken too. There are pipes inside the wall that operate the door's locks. Thinning out those pipes will break the locks and the door should open. Now that I think of it, the hippos are connected to the door as well. Stopping the hippos with paint will bypass the door's locks and that would open it. All right, we got our next mission. So we gotta thin this out like that. That's a hippo. We fill in the hippo, right? This is kind of creepy, but I like this. I like creepy Disney. Thin this out. There we go. What ride is this, by the way? Is this inspired by a ride at Disneyland? Oh, that's it? Epic Mickey Rebrushed, thanks for playing. Oh, okay. That's the end of the demo. Only 10 minutes into the video. Okay. There you go. So I guess there was like some extra stuff that we could have done in the room prior. I feel like I could have just added this to the first video that we did. But what we are going to do is we are going to take a quick look at Epic Mickey Rebrushed website. Because I have not looked at the website yet. So I want to check out the website and see what's on there. See if we can learn more about the game. This way this video will be a little bit longer. But that was the finale of the Epic Mickey Rebrushed demo. Kind of underwhelming. Like, I feel like it should have ended with like a boss fight or something. Like, give us some type of epic finale. Maybe the first boss fight would have been nice if we were able to experience that in the demo. But obviously they want us to buy the game and to experience that, because I've seen the boss fights like in the trailers and they look super fun, super cool. All right, let's get this sorted. All right, Disney Epic Mickey Rebrushed. I guess this is the trailer that was shown off, the 2024 showcase trailer. Was this like the reveal trailer? I don't know. Play the demo, pre-order now. So we did do that. These are all the platforms it's coming to: PlayStation 5, PS4, Windows, Xbox One, Xbox Series XS, and Nintendo Switch. So it's pretty much coming to everything. So if you have any of these platforms, you'll be able to play this game. I'll be playing it on the Switch, even though it won't look the best on the Switch. That's what we'll be playing it on. The game, Epic Mickey Returns. Disney Epic Mickey Rebrush brings the magic of Disney to life in a vibrant 3D platformer. This faithful remake sends Mickey Mouse on an epic journey through Wasteland, a realm of forgotten Disney characters. As Mickey, you will dive into a fantastical world. You will dive into a fantastical world. Am I saying that right? And armed with paint and thinner, shape your adventure and the faith of this alternate world. I love the art of this game. This looks so good. Wield the magic brush. Again, I said that the magic brush is just a perfect weapon for Mickey to use, just because it embodies everything that had to do with Disney animation back in the day. Help Wasteland with Mickey's magic brush. Use paint to restore beauty and harmony, or thinner to alter your environment and uncover hidden secrets. Your choices influence Mickey's destiny and change the outcome of this artistic odyssey. Will you become the epic hero Wasteland needs? Classic characters. Oh, look, there's a statue of Walt. I didn't see that in the demo. That's probably later on. Oh, this looks like Toontown. Encounter various classic characters like Oswald the Lucky Rabbit, Yen, Sid, Pete, and more as you travel between lands in Wasteland. Collect virtual Disney pins, tackle creative challenges, and uncover secrets, all while exploring classic platforming levels inspired by animated films and shorts. That is so cool. This game is going to be such a vibe. I love the fact that a collectible item in this game is Disney pins, how they're collectible in real life when you go to the Disney parks. They added that into this game. New skills, timeless magic. Use new skills for Mickey, such as dash, ground pound, and sprinting. The game's compelling story makes it an unforgettable adventure for longtime fans and newcomers alike. Join Mickey Mouse and unravel the mysteries of the Wasteland in this classic remake for modern audiences. And then we got some media stuff here, some photos from the game. Let's look at some of these screenshots. See, I think this is like the first boss, I think. And this gives off like Small World vibes, like the way the buildings are looking here. If you ever look at the ride Small World in Disneyland, this gives off like a similar vibe. Maybe this was like something that they had in the works during the time that they were trying to make Small World, and it got abandoned, because I think this game takes a lot of ideas that Disney Imagineers had for the parks and for their movies. And that's why it's called the Wasteland, because all their forgotten ideas that never came to be exist in this area. And I think that's a perfect theme for this game. It's such a cool theme as well. I guess we just gotta click through them like this. And got the enemies dressed up. Oh, they're dressed up like those singing people at Disneyland. That's cool. The game has a lot of personality. I don't necessarily like the way these enemies look, but I guess they're just supposed to be like ink blobs. But I feel like they could have made more creative enemies. But I guess if they're dressing them up in different outfits, that's kind of creative. So they'll look different. There we go. Got Walt Disney, Oswald, Rabbit. Toontown back here. Some kind of like haunted building. I like this. Mickey on a bridge using some thinner. They got the 2D platforming levels. This one was actually in the demo. The beanstalk level. And he's using some thinner on like a house. And I love the sky here. Small things. Sunset. It's a vibe. Alright. Pre-order now. So yeah, this game is up for pre-order. There's 3 different ways to pre-order this game. I'm probably just going to buy it, the regular edition off of Amazon. That's probably going to be my thing. If you pre-order it, you do get some costumes for Mickey. So it might be smart to pre-order because you do get one free thing tossed in. I'm not sure if it's an in-game unlockable or not. So if you are planning on getting the game, I would say just pre-order it from Amazon, GameStop, Best Buy, wherever. Can you not get it from Best Buy? This says you can get the collector's edition from Best Buy, but they don't have Best Buy over here for the standard edition. And this is everything you get in the collector's edition. This is pretty cool, but I think it's sold out. And they're only making 5,000 of them, limited collector's edition. So you'll get like this card that tells you which number you have out of 5,000. So definitely something that's going to be worth quite a lot in the future. But you get a steel bookcase. You get an Oswald Lucky Rabbit keychain. You get this very cool statue of Mickey. And he kind of has his paint going on here, or thinner. And he's kind of inky looking. I really like this statue. That's probably the only thing like I would really want from this. And then you got this vintage Mickey Mouse tin sign, which is cool. I mean, a lot of this stuff is cool, but I just wouldn't know what to do with it. That's the only reason I am not really pushed to really buy the collector's edition. Not that I can, because I think, again, it is sold out. You get these postcards. This is another cool thing. But again, if I'm getting postcards, I'd rather use them as postcards and actually, like, you know, send them to somebody, you know. But I know people are just going to have this as a collectible item. Most of this stuff, honestly, like if I had it, it would just be like in a box and it would be pushed into the closet. So, and the Mickey statue, I'll have to find some space to like put it. But I just feel like a lot of this stuff just takes up space. It's just clutter. If you're an epic Mickey fan or you're a big Mickey Mouse fan, I guess this could be worth it. But to me, I can live without it. I'll just take this, which is the costume pack that you get from pre-ordering the game, and you get 3 different costumes. You get like classic black and white Steamboat Willie. You get I think this is the football one, and then there's like the Taylor one. So you get 3 costumes, and that, I guess that's the big box that you get for the collector's edition that everything comes inside of. But yeah, and then the demo, obviously the demo is available to play. If you click on this, it's just the standard edition. All right. And that's a look at the website. So pretty straightforward. Screenshots. We got a trailer. We got the different editions that's coming out. Some paragraphs about the game. But yeah, Epic Mickey launches on September 24th, I believe. So it's coming out in about 3 weeks. Let me know in the comments if you guys are going to be picking up Epic Mickey or not. I'm definitely going to be picking it up. It's definitely going to be the game that I play in October. It has that spooky Halloween vibe that I want from a game. Just look at this artwork. right here. You got that creepy hand inside the ink. You got the nice spooky castle. It's got the vibes that I'm looking for like a Halloween game. But yeah, let me know in the comments. Have you guys played the demo? Did you guys enjoy it? Are you guys hyped for this game? Are you guys pre-ordering it? Are you guys getting the collector's edition? Were you able to get a collector's edition if you are one of those people that want to get the collector's edition? I actually don't even know how much the collector edition goes for, but I'm sure it's quite pricey. But I'll be just pre-ordering this off of Amazon and getting it mailed to me. But yeah, thank you for watching. Again, if you guys enjoyed this video, like the video. It definitely helps the channel out. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel if you want to stay tuned with more epic, I was going to say Mickey Mouse content. If you want more epic Mickey content, definitely subscribe to the channel. And yeah, I'll see you guys all in the next one. It's been your bro, Super Bro Zulfi. Peace.